taking a little bit of a battering today from the wind.
Yeah.
At least the rain we had yesterday is kind of gone for now, I guess.
Well, yeah, for now. This is sort of a classic change of season events. I know it's only February, but it's a little bit ahead of time. Yesterday technically was a warm day. Even though we kind of stayed cool all day, parts of Virginia were in the 70s and parts of the South were very warm. And now we're getting cold, dry air moving in, so we're getting a blustery day, which is more typical perhaps of early March around here. Here's a look at current temperatures, 53 degrees. It's been falling slowly now over the past few hours. The winds are sustained at 31. That's the constant wind. And we're seeing gusts at 43. That's the annoying wind that blows your hat off, although 31 will do that just as easily also. The dew point has fallen. That means the air is drier, and that drier air, believe it or not, is heavier air. And that heavy air is what's going to make our barometer rise, and that's why we're getting the winds today. We've got 50s across the area, sustained winds at 31, 20s, mid-30s along the coast in West Point, Williamsburg 23. A little less back toward the west. Things are starting to relax just a little bit out there. 26, though, sustained wind up in Orange. And our forecast wind gust right into the afternoon will stay in the 30-mile-an-hour plus range. Again, we could approach 40 until about 4 o'clock. After that, things will start to die down slowly. As the sun sets, the winds will start to relax a bit more and more until we get to the overnight and into tomorrow morning. Hey, minor river flooding will occur at James River West, and flood stage is 12, so 12 feet above that, we start to get minor flooding. Current level is 7.5 feet. Cresting tomorrow afternoon at 13.7, and that is minor flooding. So minor flooding will occur along the James River, and we can see a few other spots where minor flooding. We get the Meharry and the Appomattox, and a few other areas will be above flood stage for the next day or two. Clouds are starting to break up, a couple sprinkles still in a couple spots down to the south, but here's the difference. Colder air is moving in. Look at the snow that we won't see off to the west in parts of West Virginia, Kentucky, Ohio, all the way up to New York State. Some big time snow in the interior areas of the Adirondack Mountains, all the way back into western New York. Now, our temperature trend over the next few days will be cooler. 53 represents our current temperature. We've already hit our high, so it's going to continue to fall throughout the day today. Tomorrow, a chilly day at 48 degrees, partly sunny conditions. Sunday, 54, and then we bounce back both Monday and Tuesday back to the 60s, but our rain chances will accompany that as well. And then a little bit of a drop by Wednesday, and then 63 degrees as we get into next Thursday. But by then, our average will be about 50 to 51 degrees. Here's our next chance for rain. Today, the clouds will start to break up a bit. Saturday night, tomorrow night into Sunday, a little weak energy will fall through. Right now, it's just showing a couple sprinkles. We could actually see a stray flurry or a sprinkle overnight Saturday into Sunday. I think you will be in bed by then and will not notice it, but it's possible. I know it's not showing up. It's not a lot of energy with it, but it's possible. Then we get into Monday. Monday afternoon will be our next best chance for rain around here, and that should move out into the early morning hours of Tuesday. So a couple showers will remain with us, at least for the first part of Tuesday. And at this point, Wednesday looks to be dry. So a lot going on here. Again, it's almost a March-type week ahead with the gusty winds, the up-and-down temperatures, and the chances for rain. 53, 30 tonight, 40s and 50s. We hit the 60s again. There are the showers Monday by the afternoon, and a few remaining showers early on Tuesday. Wednesday looks dry, and another system could bring more rain as we get into next Thursday. Nothing too cold at night. In fact, after tonight, it's going to be tough to fall below freezing. Isn't that crazy as we head into middle February? Cheryl.